Good evening and welcome to the Business Day. I'm Javon Keys. The Bank of Jamaica says the five largest deposit-taking institutions, DTIs, held 81.7% of the market share at the end of 2023. That was slightly up from the 81.4% held in 2022. Now, the 2023 annual report published by the central bank showed there were 11 deposit-taking institutions. There were 8 commercial banks, 1 merchant bank, and 2 building societies. Now, a closer look at the market share position show that National Commercial Bank, NCB, held the largest share of DTI business at 35.4%. Bank of Nova Scotia was second at 21.9%, while JN Bank held 9.5% of the market share. Now, the BOJ says, although generally unchanged, the market share of the deposit-taking sector reflected the impact of successful growth initiatives by a few medium-sized DTIs. It says larger licensees depicted more moderate growth levels in light of current and projected economic conditions. The Financial Services Commission, FSC, has issued an advisory warning the public against investing in iMarkets Live or IM Academy. It says IML is not licensed by the FSC under the Securities or any other act in any capacity. The advisory comes against the background of allegations circulating, according to the FSC, in social media in relation to operations of the entity. The FSC is encouraging members of the public who have invested in IML or any similar investment entity to refrain from doing so, as this may result in the loss of all or part of their investment, which may not be recoverable. Additionally, the regulator is inviting the public who may have invested in IML to contact the FSC immediately. The import of fuels and lubricants cost the country $1.87 billion for January to November last year. Statin says that's 13.9% less than the $2.17 billion spent for the similar period in 2022. Now, the decline was due to lower importation of crude oil and other fuels and lubricants. Imports of crude oil were valued at $459.5 million, a 33% decline compared to January to November 2022. Now, spending on imports of other fuels and lubricants fell by 8.5% to $980 million compared to the $1.07 billion spent for January to November 2022. Now to foreign currency trading today. After a $30 million intervention, the Jamaican dollar gained 14 cents against the greenback. Banks and cambios are selling the American dollar for an average $155.74. The Canadian is going for $115.03. $195.78 is the average value for the pound. The euro will go for $171.61. And the JSE index lost 993 points today, but the Juno Market Index advanced by 15 points. Among the 47 winners were First Rock Real Estate Investments Jamaican Dollar Shares, Nutsford Express Services, MPC Caribbean Clean Energy, The Lab, and Caribbean Cream. The 46 losers included Margaritaville Turks, QWI Investments, Access Financial Services, Caribbean Flavors and Fragrances, and Paramount Trading Jamaica. Now 18 stocks closed the session, selling at the same price they started trading on Tuesday. And that's it for the Business Day. I'm Javon Keys. Please stay with us. Regional and international stories are up next.